And this one said, good morning, this is Melissa, asking you if you could pray for my little newborn baby son. He has the cold. I went to doctor twice and all I got was a nose drop, but it don't seem to be working. He's stuffed up and can hardly breathe. At times, please pray you'll get better soon, and also pray for my whole family. We'll be healthy and okay, please. Okay, Miss Melissa, I pray that you're keeping that baby not too warm. And I also pray that you're not keeping him too cold. What I do know about this here is I get too hot and I'm inside, I'll get stuffy and I'll start coughing. Right? So you might want to watch the blanket, just because he's young, you might tend to wrap him up. But there are times that they do get hot, you know? It can get hot and this can cause him to stay stuffy. So you might want to watch that. Also, you have to make sure that there is no wet things inside hanging up, hanging around. Make sure that your there is not too much rug on those things with fur flying around on it, because those things can cause him to be stuffed up as well. So you have to be careful of his atmosphere. And so, Father, I lift up this little baby boy to you this morning. I thank you, Almighty God, for the giving of his life, the fact that he's in the earth at such a time as this. We know, Almighty God, that you have ordained it to be so. And so we thank you for this life, Almighty God, even as it comes into the world to fulfill your purpose, your plan, and to bring your glory. This morning we lift him up to you, Almighty God. You heard it by what the mother says, that he's not well. And so, Almighty God, we thank you for healing him this morning. We thank you, Almighty God, as you make him good as new, healthy again, Almighty God. We come against every stuffiness in the nose right now, and I release the blood of Jesus over his life, over his family right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, I release the blood to his surrounding right now. I apply the blood of Jesus to that little boy's surrounding right now. And I come against sickness and disease and whatever condition might be in the ear. I release the blood over him right now. And I thank you, Almighty God, for healing him right now. In the name of Jesus, I ask. Amen. This one's a bless up yourself, and it's coming from Courtney, of course, in the UK. This one's a morning. Please send birthday greetings to my mother, Beverly. Beverly Tyrrell, a.k.a. Dorothy. She's living in Windsor Castle, Portland. Coming from daughter Opie and grandson Dane in Ocheraya, St. John's. Have a God bless day, Dar. So Dar, there you have it. Your daughter Opie is saying happy birthday greetings to you today. And she wanted to have a wonderful, beautiful day. The same is coming from me. Blessings, my dear. Tell the King of Kings. Can we ask him this morning to order our steps? Hallelujah to the King. And really, you know, some of us as Christians really need to pray this prayer because our steps are not ordered by Him. We just get up and we just do what we feel like because we do what we know. But it is time for us to listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit. You see, none of us as Christian is led by the Holy Spirit all the time. But the more you are led of the Spirit, the more effective your life will be. Because we as Christian, we are called to be led of Him. And so what I notice, even where church program is concerned, we don't know how to listen to Him. We don't know how to hear Him. We are concert. We just cheer program out of flesh. And we don't even know when the Lord is moving and what He's saying. And there are times when we shut down some people and think of people we are shut down when we are shut down the move of the Holy Spirit. And so we need to be hearing from God. We need to get off our surface life. We need to get out of the flesh and listen where the Spirit is concerned, because you can really disrespect the Holy Spirit and believe our people are disrespect. And so we need to pray this prayer. Order my steps in the Lord. Because there are times when the Holy Spirit is moving and you don't know it. And you just go there. And because of you in charge, you do some foolishness. But you need to be listening. Be listening. Because it's one thing when you are shut down, man. But it's another thing when God is moving through somebody and you shut them down. Because you know, understanding in our flesh, it can be dangerous. You need to be listening as Christians. And that is why, you see, because God knows that we're so fleshy and our ignorance most of the time, and just say, all right, in wink at we ignorance. But this is it. You need to come off the surface. You need to listen what God is doing. Because there are times when I go in the pulpit or when I go on stage to do something, if somebody is there that is not sucking, I can feel them. I can feel them. And I know But let me say to you this morning, let me take the time out to you this morning to say, don't stay in your flesh when you're going to do God's business. Try to come in at the spirit realm. Because it can be dangerous that you shut down somebody where God has used at the moment and time to bring about something that he wants to do. And you, because you're in your flesh, you miss it and shut down the person and shut down the spirit of God. Be careful. It could be dangerous. So this morning we want to ask to be taken into the Holy of Holies. Let us pass ourselves this morning. Let us put flesh on the outside this morning. Let us put out everything that we know to think about this morning and get past whatever is there and go straight into the presence of the King. But it's only found. Remember, you're listening to Victoria, and it's normally three segments for the day. The segment that we are now in is called Praise and Worship. During Praise and Worship, we have prayer and deliverance, where you send your requests, you call in, you say what you want to say, and we touch and agree with you for your deliverance. After which, we will go into the segment where we have the Word of God. So remember, if you want to reach us, the number is 453-1444. Number is 453-1444. If you're inside of the USA or Canada, you can listen to us from 954-338-7973. That's 954-338-7973. And of course, if you're on the web streaming, you can also tune in to YouTube, Styles FM Radio. Instagram, follow us at Styles FM. Twitter, it's at Styles FM 96.1. And it's Facebook, Styles FM 96.1 fan page. You can also stream live on ustream.com if you want to be on your computer on the internet. You can listen to us by way of telephone in the UK by calling 033-0010-3322. 033-0010-3322. Now you can take your phone wherever you're going, you can have Styles on the go. So remember, the local number to reach us is 453-1444. And if you want to find us on your internet live, all you have to do is go to that Google search engine and type in Portland radio station in Jamaica. You will pick us up right there down there where you say you stream TV, Styles FM. This one said, good morning, Sister V. The little boy who fell from the orchid tree a few weeks ago is back from the KPH with only a broken arm. Thanks. Without God and your prayer, we couldn't have made it, Miss Brown. Miss Brown, bless up yourself, sweetheart. See, this is a practice. It's not easy to be still and know that God is God. You see, when you live into this flesh, you have to train yourself to be free, to be still.
Have been blessed by this ministry, we would like to give you the opportunity to partner with us and help us in sharing the cost to win the loss. To send your gift or offering, please call us at 583-4479 or email us at vsharpmiller@gmail.com.
You can't afford to miss it. The Road to Glory, your Sunday morning gospel and inspirational music program on Styles 96.1 from 9 a.m. until 12 noon. Tune in. Styles, the People's Station.
Join DP on Styles FM 96.1 for a new touch to praise and worship. Total praise! It's inspirational and uplifting. This and every Sunday from 12 to 4 p.m. on Styles FM 96.1. For the joy of the
Lord. Hi, this is Vonsil Belcher, and you're listening to Styles 96.1, 96.7, the People Station, with Victoria Miller.
You're tuned into Light in My World.
Thank you.
See, as I was saying, it's not easy to be still in this flesh that we live in. We have to learn to train ourselves to allow God to do what He predestined to do in our life. And sometimes He can't even do it because we are about ourselves, our own business. We are always on top of our stuff. And so as long as you are working, doing what you know how to do, then God will not interfere. But can we be still this morning? Can we get off our stuff? Can we give it over? Can we just know that God is not a man that He should lie? He's not a man. He's able to perform whatever He says, whatever He promised. He's more than capable of doing it. And so can we be still this morning? This one said, good morning, Sister Victoria. I'm asking you for prayer for the Jackson family in Lenox, Orange Bay, especially my mother, Mrs. Elaine Jackson. Please pray for her strength and God. She's a child of God, but the devil wants to destroy our family. Please pray for us. So, Father God, I thank you this morning that you are our God. I thank you that you are our Lord. I thank you that you sent Jesus Christ, our Savior. I thank you, Almighty God, for all the wonderful blessings that you give unto us through your grace. This morning, Father God, we know, Almighty God, that when we pray, it's not something that you're going to do, but it is what is already done. And so this morning, because we know it is finished, we ask. Because your word said we should ask and we will receive. And so this morning, Almighty God, we thank you for the life of the Jacksons. Father God, we lift up the Jacksons family to you right now. We thank you, Almighty God, that your hands are not short this morning. Father God, before you put them into existence, you put their provisions into existence before them, Almighty God. And so whatever they need, Almighty God, whatever is the demand upon your life today, Almighty God, you have already made it available this morning. And so I come into you this morning, Almighty God. I'm standing in faith, believing you for them, for their deliverance, Almighty God. Whatever the enemy is doing in the Jackson's family right now, we rebuke him in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We shut him down today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We command him right now to take his hands off of them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Father, we superimpose your will, your purpose, your destiny over their lives in the name of Jesus Christ right now. And we come against every setup and every conspiracy of the enemy this morning. We shut down the forces of darkness against this family life right now in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you as you cause yourself to manifest big and large and wonderful in their lives. In Jesus' name we ask it. Amen. Can we receive that this morning? God, God, God. You see, even as I'm on the radio station, there's a lot of person who is praying against me. Now, but I believe say, me no feel no, me say me feel no even while me sitting in this studio. But the devil is a liar this morning. Paula, you're live.
Good morning.
Good morning, sweetheart.
I am Miss Brown, never but tell out of the attitude. Thank you, but you pray for me.
Hallelujah. Thank God for you too, sweetheart. Have a great day now.
Thanks.
Hear every change.
So there we testify that little boy is well. You hear him just call a while ago at him drop out of the apple tree one day when everybody think him all dead. But we thank God this morning that he's alive and well and kicking.
What are you troubled about? I'm a doctor. Have I ever lost the case? I'm a lawyer in the courtroom. I'm a heart fixer and a mind regulator. I am your ministry. I am your peace. I am your source. Just
Yes, good morning.
I'm calling from Sydney. I would like to pray for me and my family. Thank you. My name is Sister Ali.
You're breaking up. I'm hardly hearing you, sweetheart.
Good morning, Sister P. I'm calling from St. Mary.
Okay.
I'd like you to pray for me and my family, Sister Reddy and her children.
And the name is?
Sister Reddy.
Reddy?
Yes.
All right, Sister Reddy. You said you want prayer for you and your children.
Yes, Sister.
All right, lift your feet with me, sweetheart. I'll pray as you come out of the air.
Because of who you are, yes, I do. Worship.
We know we worship him because he's God. He's just God, and that's just who he is. Nobody can alter that. Nobody can change that. Nobody can move him. He's Almighty God. He's unmovable, unstoppable. Unchangeable. That's who he is this morning.
Because of who you are, I give you.
There are some things that I'm feeling, but I want the enemy to know, and all of who pray against to know, that if God be for us, who can be against us? That we are moving forward. We are not about quitting, because guess what? Me and lift up long time and put to the plow, and so me not take it back. So all you are trying, is in vain. I want to say to the devil this morning, you know so you don't lose already, but you fight one losing battle anyway. You are a loser. Because guess what? I'm already seated in Christ. And you can't move me out. And me not move myself out. So me want to know how me go come out. You're fighting a losing battle.
We came tonight to give you the praise.
Because of who you are,
we're gonna lift our
hands. And so I want to make some decree this morning. Your kingdom come, God. Your will be done. Let your kingdom advance and be established through preaching, teaching, and healing. Let the gates of my life and city be open for the King of Glory to come in. Lord, you reign. You are clothed with majesty and strength. Your throne is established of old. You are from everlasting. Lord, you are great, a great king above all gods. Let the Eden hear that the Lord reign this morning. Lord, you reign. Let the people tremble. Let the earth be moved. Lord, you have prepared your throne in the heavens, and your kingdom rules over all. Let man bless the Lord in all place of his domain, or of his dominion. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures throughout all generations. Let man speak of the glory of your kingdom and talk of your power. Let men know your mighty acts and your glorious majesty of your kingdom. Let your kingdom come through deliverance. Let the gospel of the kingdom be preached in my region, and signs and wonder following. Father, I receive the kingdom because it's yours. It is your good pleasure to give it to me. Let the righteousness, peace, and joy of the kingdom be established in my life. Let the kingdom of this world become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ. Let the saints possess the kingdom. Overthrow the thrones of wicked kingdoms. Preserve me unto your heavenly kingdom. Let the scepter of your kingdom be released. I seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things are added unto me. Break in pieces and consume every demonic kingdom that resists your dominion. Let all dominions serve and obey you, O Lord. I decree and declare those things done. Devil, you are a liar. You always will be a liar. You don't know to talk truth. Everything that comes out of your mouth is lie. And so this morning we shut you down. We come against your operation. We shut down every conspiracy that you put together this morning. And I render them null and void in the name of Jesus. And we said, rule. Rule, Jesus. Reign in and through the lives of your people. Let your name be exalted this day. This one said, good morning, Sister Vicky. Blessings always. Keep up the good work. May God bless you and your family always. Joy from St. Mary. Bless you, sweetheart. It's so good to hear from you, Sister Joy. I hear from you last week, and I know that you still text from time to time and you are listening. I just want to say to you, God, richest blessing on your life. I received that blessings just now. This one said, good morning, Sister. How are you? Please, I'm asking you to pray for my sis. She got 8 subjects and want to go to college, but don't have any money. And so these are the prayer requests this morning. You might hear some of them and say, what am I asked to pray about? Look here, people trust God and need God. No matter what the situation may be this morning, if you can be still and see God for who he is, then truly he's amazing. He's more than able to fulfill all of that which you can ever think of or ask of. And so, Father, we lift up this sister to you. We thank you for salvation coming to her if she's not saved. We release salvation, Almighty God, and release your order over her life right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord God, that before time was, you, God, have predestined in her life to be as in the earth for such a time as this. And so, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Father God, we lift her up to you today. We thank you, Almighty God, for every dreams that she have, Almighty God. For this cause, you send Jesus Christ into the earth realm, Almighty God. Everything that seems impossible is made possible through Jesus Christ this morning. And so, Father God, where she have this dream of furthering her education in college, Almighty God, we thank you, Almighty God, that you are a way maker. We thank you, Almighty God, that not only you are a way maker, but you have already made her way. And so I pray, Almighty God, that if she's not walking in your pathway, she will come into your pathway, that she can see the way that you have made. And so I thank you, Almighty God, as you open that door, Almighty God, for somebody, whether it be an auntie, an uncle, a cousin, somebody, Almighty God, will see the need, Almighty God, will call her, will get in touch with her this day, Almighty God, will ask her what can they do for her, Almighty God, and will bless her, Almighty God, in this era. Father, I lift her up to you today, Almighty God, because, Father God, we understand that in this time and season, Father God, it is your goodness, Almighty God, in her life that is going to cause her to look your way and to see you for who you are. This morning, Father God, I thank you for that dream coming true for her, Almighty God. Because you want it to come true. You want her to shine. You want her to be educated, Almighty God. And so we come into you on this behalf, Father God. We know, Almighty God, that it is your will. And so we pray your willing to be in this morning. And we thank you for it being done. In Jesus' name. Call her, you're live. Good morning.
Good morning, Sister Vic.
How are you? This is the garden.
Fine, thank you, ma'am.
Oh, what are going on now?
It's a thing now going, but it's still under the struggle.
Okay, convention done now.
Yes, ma'am, convention finished. And we have 1 day of crusade, and it's over.
Okay, okay.
I'm asking you kindly to pray for all the students who will be sitting the grade 1 test tomorrow. Most of them is from my school.
Okay, so you have a grade 1 test tomorrow?
Up by the Apricot Junior High and Primary School.
Okay, okay.
I'm asking you to pray for all the students.
So how was the convention, sis?
Well, it was good.
Was good.
We're having a baptism the first Sunday of next month.
Okay, wonderful.
Yes, Pastor Shaw is our minister. Oh. I'm asking you to pray for him also.
All right.
My grandson, Pedro Powell. I'm asking you to pray for them for me.
What is his name?
They can come to Pedro Powell. He will be sitting the grade one test tomorrow.
Pedro, you see?
Pedro Powell.
Okay. All right, Miss Garden, thanks for calling.
Oh, God bless you, Sister Vic, and continue your good work.
Thank you, sweetheart. Bye-bye. My mind, my soul belong to you. Can we tell him this morning? And so, Father God, we lift up Reddy to you, Sister Reddy. We thank you, Almighty God, for she and her children this morning, Almighty God. Father God, it is not by accident that they are in the earth for such a time as this. You know every plans that you have for Sister Reddy's life and her children. And so whatever it is, Almighty God, that is hindering them from coming to this plan, from coming into this purpose this morning, we curse it in the name of Jesus. We shut down everything, every hindrance over those lives right now. We pull them down, we shut them down, we render them null and void this morning, and we speak live to Reddy and family. In the name of Jesus, we pull them up in the spiritual realm. We pull up, we call forth the spirit of Reddy to arise. In the name of Jesus Christ, I call you forth this morning, Sister Reddy. I command your spirit to live. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I pull you up to the next level this morning. And I thank you, Father God, as you direct our path. Hallelujah. I thank you, Almighty God, as you pull her up into the spirit realm, out into the deep, where she can speak with you and talk with you and hear your Holy Spirit this morning. Father, I thank you, Almighty God, for provisions. I thank you for opening doors. I thank you, Almighty God, that where lack is, Almighty God, I speak plenty. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak to every door that are shut that is supposed to be open unto them. And Father God, I command that door to be open now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And every door that are open that is supposed to be shut, we close them this morning. And Father God, we thank you for fulfillment coming out of Sister Reddy's life and family. We thank you, Almighty God, as they magnify you. We thank you for the honor and the glory that you will receive out of their lives. Father God, let your will be done and let your kingdom come upon them. In Jesus' name. Father God, we lift up Sister Garden to you. We lift up Minister Shaw to you this morning. We lift up her grandson to you this morning. Father, you know the aspects. You know the circumstances. You know just everything that is there, Almighty God. And so, Lord God, we thank you, Almighty God, as you, Almighty God, show forth yourself great in those lives, as you allow them, Almighty God, to see you for who you are this morning. Father God, we come against everything that is unlike you. And moreover, Almighty God, we tear off every veil. We make you this morning clearer to them, Almighty God, that they will look into to you. They will see your face this morning, God. They will understand this morning, God. They will know you for who you are this morning, God. I thank you, Almighty God, as you make self real to these people. And Father, I lift up the school to you, the children that are going to be sitting that exam. I come against every spirit of fear that would want to linger in those minds to torment those small children this morning. And I shut it down. I shut it down in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I release the Spirit of God to the classrooms this morning where they are going to be sitting that exams. In the name of Jesus Christ, I make that classroom ready. I make the atmosphere ready. I release God into those classrooms this morning, Father God. And I thank you, Spirit of God, as you over and over into those classrooms, that the gates of hell will not prevail against those children. We thank you for your will being done in their lives, even as you so ordained them. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen. This one said, good morning. Please pray for my Cherry to have a safe delivery of our son. Hopefully, this coming week from husband Corey. I know that is his wife, Cherry. And so, Father God, we thank you for Corey and his family this morning. We thank you for that baby boy coming into this world, even as you have so ordained him, Almighty God. We lift him up to you already. We speak life to him, even inside the womb where he's kicking. Father, we thank you for safe delivery for both mother and child. We ward off every plans of the enemy this morning, and we speak life over mother and son. In the name of Jesus Christ, we speak safe delivery. We come against everything that is unlike you, God. We shut them down this morning. We come against every setup of the enemy, every conspiracy of Satan this morning to abort that child. We come against it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Father God, we ward him off. We mash up him plan this morning. And we thank you, Almighty God. We set angel in that delivery room right now to make it ready. In the name of Jesus Christ. And we thank you, Father, for your will being done over those lives. In Jesus' name.
Belongs to you. Hey, it all belongs to you.
This one said, good morning. Just keep your praise up. No weapon that form against you shall prosper.
Everything that we are, Lord, it all belongs to
you. The devil is a liar. God is there for you. He loves you, and no one can move you where God has put you. This is coming from you on.
I give myself away. So
this is coming. Put you on the rock to stay. And keep up. Keep you in his presence. He hide you. So keep your praise up. I'm praying for you. This is coming from Jer from Cox Street, Port Maria. And I was in Cox Street the other day, you know, Jer. I came to Cox Street and I visit a church, one of those Shiloh Apostolic. I was there giving out flyers for the meeting that we have in Brimerville High School. I came to Cox community.
What would happen?
So good morning, Jared. Thank you for praying for me. Continue to pray for me while I do the same for you, sweetheart.
Here I am. Here I am.
caller, you're live. Good morning. Sorry, I missed that call. Can we tell him?
Myself to you. Oh, my life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself. I give
this one's a good morning, Sister Victoria. Paula, you're live. Good morning.
Morning, Miss Victoria.
How you do, sweetie?
I'm not by. I listen every Sunday morning.
Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Manzai, Motown.
Okay, good to hear from you.
Yes, ma'am. I listen to you in the morning. Oh, you're so sweet. I'd like to meet you one day, ma'am.
You never come to the concert?
I couldn't come because I have a 104-year-old lady to look about.
Oh, you're the person who take care of that lady?
Yes.
Okay.
I've been looking about her for about 12 years now.
You said you live in Motown?
Siemensville, yes, but I work in Siemensville.
Okay, we are going to be in Motown, but it's not light in my world. It's Chem Ministry. That's a ministry that I go to. We are going to be coming to Motown on the 29th to have an open here meeting.
Oh, the 29th of next month?
Of this month.
Oh, that is next week, Friday.
Right, so you will see me there if you come to that meeting and invite others, invite everybody if you come out.
What time it is?
I think it's in the evening. Somewhere there we should start roughly about 6 o'clock.
All right. I'll try.
All right.
Yes. So, Miss Victor Abbas' son, you see?
Mm-hmm.
He was married, but his wife leave him.
Okay.
Yes, and he's in America now. But I'd like you to pray for him. Meanwhile, I am praying for Miss Victor. He can get a job. But he owes some little debt out here.
Okay.
And my pay that I'm working cannot cover it.
So you want us to pray that he will get his jobs together and take care of the debt?
Yes, he was a pastor, but I don't know. He intended the interview, but he don't get the work as yet.
All right. So we pray for him and believe together, all right?
All right, Miss Vikram. Thank you, ma'am.
All right, sweetheart. See you soon.
Yeah.
For his presence, some of you just want him. Just show me that you're real. I need you. But I want you to know that you're...
If you have been blessed by this ministry, we would like to give you the opportunity to partner with us and help us in sharing the cost to win the loss. To send your gift or offering, please call us at 583-4479 or email us at vsharpmiller@gmail.com.
Mr. Brown, the work material done, you know. What me fi do?
Check Robinson's and Sons Hardware, man. Them have everything you need and more. They are at 18 West Palm Avenue, Port Antonio, Portland. Paints, nails, doors, everything to meet your hardware needs and much more. Call them at 993-9763 or 382-6209 and email them at sandhardware@gmail.com.
Mr. Brown, me get everything we need quick and fast.
Sure, maybe could have just stopped the chatting so we could have done the work just as fast.
What was that, Johnny?
No, man. We just said Robinson and Sons are going good.
Robinson's and Sons Hardware. We are always here to serve you.
Planning a party? Club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM, for the most effective way to exploit your marketing marketing dollar.
Relive the music memories. Solid Gold Star Sundays from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. with your host, Captain Baker, on your favorite station, the Beeper Station, Stars FM 96.1. Reminisce on the past with the music. Flashback on what it is that was. It's a program you don't want to miss on a Sunday. Solid Gold Stars from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. You join me. Let us recap the music of yesteryear. Cool.
Live the best music experience.
Feel the fire. Feel the heat. As Fire Greg takes you back in time with Sunday Peppering on Stars FM 96.1. Sundays 8 to 12 midnight. He'll deliver the spice and sauce you seek to begin the work week only on Stars FM.
Need a lifestyle change? Tired of the same old, same old? Sister Peace Restaurant in Hope Bay is a healthy alternative. Vegetarian dishes, natural juices, puddings, shakes, and much more. Open Monday to Saturday, 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. Look out for the pretty, pretty building just outside of Hope Bay. Telephone number 532-0723.
Hi, this is Vonsell Belcher, and you're listening to Styles 96.1, 96.7, The People Station with Victoria Miller.
You're tuned into Light in My World.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you, sir?
Yes, I never tell Victoria good morning this morning. So I feel bad. So I don't know if I never try and keep it every morning. You know?
Brother Courtney.
Yeah, Courtney.
We want this up, me, and I just never have the number for sending you the information. I have, couldn't find the number.
Yeah, because the message is online, you know, on WhatsApp, but, you know, I think you're not online.
No, I guess me not in range of the internet. So when me not in range of the internet, me can't me not see the WhatsApp message them.
All right then. I will call you after the service finish and then you take it from there, yeah?
All right. Call me for myself.
Definitely.
Right?
Definitely. I'm waiting on you anyway, yeah?
All right.
You send me that, yeah?
All right.
Okay, thanks. Take care, yeah?
You too. Closer than before. Follow your life. Good morning.
Please give me the number. I would like to donate something to the ministry. Please give me the number.
583-4479.
Hold on, please.
583.
Uh-huh.
44.
Yeah.
79.
All right, ma'am.
All right.
Yeah.
So, Father, we lift up the young man to you. Father, we thank you, Almighty God, that you are God in every aspect, in every circumstances. You are Almighty God. And why we can come to you with all our troubles, all our chaotic situation, it's because we know you love us. And you said, Almighty God, in your words, you give us the assurance of your word that you will never leave us nor forsake us. You said you would marry to the backsliders. You said in your word so much to us that would drive us to come to you, Almighty God, with our troubles. Father God, I lift up this woman's son in America to you right now, Almighty God. You know of his problem. You know of his circumstances. You know everything about him, Almighty God. And so we lift him up to you, Almighty God, having an understanding that you are King and you are Lord and you can do all things. Father God, we pray, Almighty God, whatever the job situation is, Almighty God, that you will make it available, Almighty God, for him. In Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you right now as you open up those doors for him, Almighty God, so his family can take care of the debt. There is no situation, Almighty God, that you, God, have not already provided for. And so, Almighty God, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. We thank you this morning, Almighty God, as you show up great and mightily in these people's life. We thank you, Almighty God, that you are the lift up of our heads. And that with you, we know that all things are ready. And so, Lord, have your way in and through these lives. In Jesus' name I pray. Hello, you're live. Good morning.
Hello, Pleasant. Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
I just want to say a word of prayer for the people in Style FM. We just want Father God to ever cover them, ever shield them, ever protect them, that they can be able to save, to provide things over the stairway. I just want to ask Father Jesus this morning to guide and keep Gospel in family. Child FM family, all the mother child and the radio station this morning. Ask this morning, dear Father God, I'm asking to cover them, Jesus, like you never covered them before. Lord God, I put this young lady before you this morning, dear Father God. Lord God, reach out and bless her, dear Father Jesus. Remember our family. Holy Jesus, I'm asking, dear Lord, I want to thank you for this morning and the morning that you give unto us this morning, dear Father Jesus. Your grace and your mercy wake up this morning in our right mind, that you can able to ever listen this radio station, the joy, peace, and comfort this morning, dear Jesus, while I say thanks in Jesus' name.
Oh, okay, sister, thanks for praying.
God bless you.
Bless you too, sweetheart. Okay, I want to take the time out to pray for Nikisha. Caller, you're live. Good morning.
Sister V, could you give me your number, please?
It's 583-4479.
583-4479. Thank you.
All right. I'm running to you. Okay, want to take the time out to lift up Nikisha and her husband to God. Father, we lift up Nikisha right now, God. We thank you, Almighty God, that you are King in their lives. We thank you that there is none like you. We thank you, Almighty God, that all that you have provided for them for life and godliness is already finished. Father God, where their provisions are, Father God, you told us, Almighty God, that it is finished. And so where they are struggling, the husband is struggling to find a job. We thank you for that job, Almighty God. We thank you as you open the door. We thank you, Almighty God, as you break every fetters. We thank you as you move every endurance. We speak to the endurance of a job right now that is hindering your son from having his livelihood and his family. Father God, we speak to those endurance this morning. And we thank you, Almighty God, for wisdom. We thank you, Almighty God, for understanding coming to that husband right now in the US of E. And Father God, we thank you, Almighty God, for the job that you have predestined for him, Almighty God, to walk in. Nothing will stop him. Nothing will block him. We release him this morning into that job. And we thank you, Lord God, for that testimony coming forth in Jesus' name. Father God, we speak strength to the wife this morning. We cover under your blood. We cover that entire family right now under your blood, Almighty God. And we thank you for victory. In Jesus' name. Lord God, we want to make mention of that young man who at certain time of the year just takes sick. This mother said he has been watching it and she know that it is a spell because it have a certain time to happen. And so, Father God, we come against that spell right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever has been placed on his life, Father God, we thank you, Almighty God, that you have already made the preparation for him to be delivered, for him to be set free when you send Jesus Christ. And so, Almighty God, this does not take you by surprise because his deliverance is in Jesus. And so, Father God, we release the blood of Jesus over that young man right now. We call his name Wayne. We release the blood of Jesus to you right now, Wayne. We take authority over that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, you know where Wayne is right now. And so I send forth the Spirit of God to arrest every other spirit that has been said to your life in the name of Jesus Christ. We capture them this morning in the name of Jesus. We arrest those spirits this morning in the name of Jesus and release the blood of Jesus to your surrounding. Father, we thank you right now. We bind them and we send them back to the lower region of hell this morning in the name of Jesus. We destroy them in the name of Jesus. We shut them down in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Father God, as you deliver Wayne this morning. We thank you, Almighty God, that because of this day, Wayne's life will never be the same. Wayne's life will never be the same. We call off every attack. We come against it in the name of Jesus. We nullify the spells this morning. We mash them up in the name of Jesus. We speak death to those spells. And we say to those spirits that has been set an assignment this morning, your assignment is over. Your assignment is over. You are not assigned anymore. You have no more assignment to that person's life. In the name of Jesus, we shut down your assignment this morning. And Father, we thank you, Almighty God, for delivering him. We speak salvation over his life right now. We speak salvation and we speak the order of God into his life. In the name of Jesus Christ. And Father God, as he see you work on his behalf, I thank you, Almighty God, that if he's not saved, he will give his life to you so you can maintain his life from every wicked spirit and everything that wants him to come under that attack every time, every certain time of the year. Father, we thank you right now as you change that and as you liberate him and put him into your kingdom. In Jesus' name we ask, amen.
Make it the cry of your heart.
I want to see.
I want to live in the secret place. Show me your face.
I know this is where a lot of you have been. You can make this the cry of your heart. I'm not satisfied.
I'm not satisfied.
Still I want more.
I want to see your power.
it in me. Reveal your glory and your power in us, God, through your people. Then show me your face. Our cry. I want to see your glory. I want to live
the secret place.
Show me your face. Say,
so we have come to the end of that segment. We move on to the segment where we have the Word of God coming to you live from Styles FM Radio, from the program Light in My World, through the person Victoria Miller. Now this morning my topic is going to be how to manifest abundance. Jesus Christ announced that he is here to give us abundant of life. Of course, when we get saved, a whole lot of us as Christians, we don't see the abundance of life coming out of our life. And we wonder, what is this? Why are we not seeing certain things? Where are we? But have we received? Because you see, so many times why we don't see the abundance, it's because we don't know the gospel. And what is the gospel? People mix you up and people preach all kind of different something and say them I preach gospel. But the truth of it, it's not everything that is preached today in our world. Or most of what has been already preached in the church that we know to be the church, it's not the gospel. Because for one, the gospel means good news, right? And what we hear, they are so far from good news. Because what we preach is legalism. We preach the law, we preach all of these things, and it is not the gospel. The gospel is what we understand. The gospel is a content that we come to look into and to see how to operate in this kingdom of heaven system. And so, when I said how to manifest the abundance, that is what I mean. Because we need to see abundance coming from our life. Jesus Christ saying, configure abundance life. And it's not just spiritual life. It is supposed to be manifested because we are natural. We are spirit first, but we live in a natural body. And so whatever is going to be coming forth out of us, we need to see them manifesting in the natural. Hallelujah. And so this morning, here is another content of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Now, after all that is happening around us, why would Victoria want to come and choose this topic this morning? Why? Because it's necessary. It is necessary to see and to understand these things. Because if you never look into these things, you will not manifest it. You will never see the abundance coming out of your life. God wants the church to manifest his grace, especially in today's day. Hallelujah. And we are seeing a financial meltdown. But as a church, I come to tell the church not to be afraid, but to believe God. Believe God's word and think on them. Think on them. What he says is true. Keep them on your mind at all time. It doesn't matter how threatening the situation might look. It doesn't matter how bad it might seem. It doesn't matter how long something dead. Keep God's words on your mind. Keep it on your mind and think on them. Do not allow anything to move you from what the word of God says to you. It's let us trust God together this morning and believe God for the manifestation of abundance. Now, success and prosperity is a result of God's grace. In other words, because of his love for us, he favors us with the potential of living and having a prosperous life. Now, this favor is born out of his love for us. Our God is concerned about our needs, and that is why he didn't leave us comfortless. He's concerned this morning. He didn't leave us comfortless. He sent us the Holy Spirit. And why he sent us the Holy Spirit is not just for us to run around in church, even though sometimes it's necessary. It's not just for us to cast out demons, even though sometimes it's necessary. It's not just for the spiritual things, but the Holy Spirit is sent to us to lead us into all truth. And this abundance that we need to see manifestation coming out of, it's the Holy Spirit who is going to lead us into the truth of this also. Hallelujah. And so let us look into Romans 12 and verse 2. Romans 12 and verse 2 said, "Don't be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind so that you may prove what is the good, well-pleasing, and perfect will of God." That's what my Bible read. In your Bible, it might say, what is the good, what is the perfect, what is the appropriate, what is the expected result? What is the will of God this morning? So now Romans 12 and verse 2 tell us how to get started in the manifestation of our kingdom abundance. It said, don't be conformed. And so many times we see people just join one church and conform to the denominational rule. And they are right. But I want to say to you this morning that it is not by joining a church and being conformed to this church and the denominational rule that change is going to come out of your life. The change that you need to see coming out of your life cannot be done through conforming to church rule. Hallelujah. And so Paul tell us how to get result, how to see manifestation of kingdom abundance coming into the natural. He said, be ye transformed. It takes transformation. And this transformation that is going to be happening to us now, it is going to be through the word of God. It is for us to renewing our mind, to renew our mind with the word. Being conformed to a church or a denomination rule and tradition does not allow us to prove what is good, what is acceptable, and what is the perfect will of God. But we must adhere to the word of God. It is when we receive what the word of God says to us. It is when we receive what the word of God tells us that our mind is being transformed. This renewal of the mind is about us who are born again, allowing ourselves what the word of God says to culture our minds. Where our mind is concerned, we in the natural is already culture with what we know from we are baby, from we born and come up, our mind is set in a one way. But we need to get the word of God into our mind this morning, and we need to culture our mind with the word of God. We need to change our mind. We need to change our thinking. We need to put off what we know for what God says. We need to exchange our way of thinking for God's way of thinking. We need to exchange our way of belief for God's way of belief. Our way of know-how for God's way of doing things. We need to culture our mind that way. And I know it's not easy. And so that is why it cannot be a one-time thing. Our mind is not just cultured when we read the Bible one time. There are times when we are waiting on God for some stuff to change. And we have to continually adhere ourselves to the Word of God. We have to read them over. And that is why people go to church and the different seminar, because they need the Word of God to be feasting on them, to be chewing them over like cod chewing animal. We have to look them over. When something comes to you and it seems threatening and it seems like there is no way out, you have to go back to the Word of God. You have to begin to look back into the Old Testament, what God did do in some people's life and how they come over. You have to encourage yourselves with the Word of God this morning. So don't think that your situation that you see are going to kill you. But look back in the Word of God. Each time you feel threatened, each time you feel like you're not going to make it, you just go back to the Word and make the Word encourage you afresh. Let it restore you. We have to renew our mind. We have to have our mindset culture with the Word of God. We can have liberty in this life if we believe. Right? We can have liberty in this life if we believe. We don't have to be stuck in lock. We don't have to stay the way we are. We can be liberated this morning. And so a lot of Christians are not triumphant. They live in defeat because they don't know what the Word of God says about them. They don't believe because all we teach most time in a church are legalism. And so because we teach legalism, the people, they don't know how to manifest the goodness of God. They don't know how to manifest what is in the kingdom laid up for us. And so it's time we leave legalism one side and stop preach man philosophy and man rule and tradition and get with the kingdom teaching. Get with what the Word said. Jesus Christ commanded the disciple, you know, to preach and teach the kingdom. And what is in the kingdom for us is good news. It is information to show us how to manifest all of what is inside of the kingdom for us. And so if we never get this teaching, we'll never have the victory. That is why some of us can't wait upon God to come. Every day we are saying, soon come. And every day we are saying, me want to go ahead and rest. Me tired of this old world because you are not having any victory in your life. And God intend you to triumph in this life. And so people can't wait to go to heaven. Every time you see one believer nowadays, all them talk about heaven, me want to go home, me want dead and go home. Why they not have no victory? Why you not have the victory? God intend for you to triumph in this life. This life and also the life to come. Because we are more than conquerors. And so this morning, we are going to be looking in the Word of God. The same Jesus who died for us to be forgiven and free from sin. It's the same Jesus who died for us to be free from lock, you know. The same Jesus. And so we just activate grace with forgiveness. And we are all our circumstances are concerned, we bawl and complain like the world. And we never understand that this Jesus who died, he died for all of our difficulties, you know, matter what them be. He died to put them in a right order. Let's look at prosperity. What is it? What is prosperity? Because when some people preach prosperity in the church, people say them I preach peer prosperity then talk about, and them I preach I just prosperity preacher. You need to understand it, you know, that prosperity is not a gospel. We say we are preach prosperity gospel, but this is it. Prosperity is not a gospel. There is only one gospel. But guess what? Prosperity is a part of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so we not feel too relaxed when we hear about them something, because we not believe that so we feel prosper. We believe not just physical Christians suffer, and then we sing, it is a hard road to travel. And we find all of the religious songs them and we sing them. And at them, then we put to mind pan and think pan them and say, ah, I just want God. That's not how Jesus Christ intended. Jesus Christ never come down here and take them nail their eye and their foot and their lashes there where them pull out all their flesh out their back and disfigure in face and bear all of them something there for you go to earth in a hell. In do it that you might be triumphant in this life also. And so if we are not having the victory, you need to set yourself to have the victory. You need to come into that position. You need to learn what is the gospel and what the information he have for you. Because that is why you're not having the victory. Let us look. So we said, what is prosperity? What is it? Prosperity is more than money, but it is also money. It is also money. Is also money. The first thing to do where our financial prosperity is concerned is to change our minds. Change the way you think. And this is a big area that it is affected by all the world. Where our financial status is concerned, everybody a quarrel, everybody a murmur, everybody a be hard. Right? It's only those of us who are in the kingdom and understand how kingdom system function can stay on the inside and look out and say, me don't know how the world I make it. Because we understand that we live by faith and we depend upon God for what we need each day. So we don't have to murmur, we don't have to complain. We can thank God and praise him for all that he has already done for us. Hallelujah. So the first thing to do where our financial prosperity is concerned is to change our minds. Change the way you think. Because soul prosperity is life prosperity. So if you can think it, you will prosper, even as your soul also prosper. When we change the way we think and accept God's way of thinking, we are going to find out what is good, what is acceptable, and what is the perfect will of God. Now I'm here to prove to you this morning that financial prosperity is the perfect will of God also. It is the perfect will of God. How do we expect to live a life of lack? We are nothing when we have a full spirit. We have a full spirit where nothing is missing and nothing is broken in our spirit, man. So how then we just accept lack, accept defeat, accept everything what the enemy has shown in our life when we come into this born-again process where we have been given a new spirit, man, where nothing is missing and nothing is broken? We can't accept defeat. We can't accept defeat with that on the inside of us. Because we have been given a new nature. We have been given a new spirit, man. Where all things have passed away and everything become new. We are a new creation on the inside where our spirit, man, is concerned. And in our new creation, we have nothing missing and nothing broken. And if we are going to live from that area of our life, the Bible says we are to be led of the spirit. If we are going to walk in the spirit, then we too must allow what is on the inside to flow to the outside, where we will see nothing missing and nothing broken. But how do we do that? Third John. Let us look at Third John 3. Third John 1, verse 2 to 3. Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be healthy, even as your soul prosper. For I rejoice greatly when brothers came and testify about your truth, even as you walk in the truth. Now, that's what me talk about. We have to walk in the truth. And so, here is Paul writing. Paul or John, one of them there. Here is John writing that look here, in wish above all that we prosper, even as we soul also prosper. And so if we are going to prosper, we first have to get it into our mind.
I bring it to you this morning so you can have a mindset that you were created for prosperity. You're not just created to go through life and have luck and face with all of them something and dead and go in a sickness, disease, and poverty. No, that is not the mindset. That is not the intention of God. Paul and all of them disciples, they might have set the pace and go through some stuff. Not that you have to go through the same thing as them. No, they already gone through it so that we could have a better life also. They went through these things. It means, you know, this something when we go through, you know, as a mother, you know, me people not supposed to go through them, you know, because me set the pace already. These disciples, these apostles, they set the pace for us now that exist in today's world can prosper. Because they give us information. They give us the gospel to show us how to walk it out, how to manifest it. But what we are still doing, we are still preaching legalism. And that is why we can't see the benefit, the rights, and the something where God gives to us through grace manifesting from our life. So in order for us to prosper in every way, you have to prosper in your soul first. You have to think it. The Bible says, as a man think it, so is he. So this morning, I pull you today. I pull you into that mindset that prosperity is also for the sons. It is for the sons. You hear some other people take on the name and then put prosperity along with it. A thief, the devil thief. A robbing, rob the name. Because look here. Prosperity no means you have a whole heap of money neither. Because there's a lot of persons out there with a lot of money and they're not prosperous. They're not all right, they're sick. Hallelujah. So I said soul prosperity is life prosperity. We have to change the way we think. Right? Financial prosperity is the will of God for our life. So when we understand now that prosperity not just means money, it not just mean money, because we have a lot of people out there, we claim to them rich and they're miserable. Look at that man the other day that died. He's one of the richest comedian, and he go up on stage and make other people happy and yet still in commit suicide. Come on, can we look around us? That is not prosperity neither. Having a lot of money, you can't have a lot of money and still miserable, still sick, still forsaken, still rejected. My God, you know how much something some people do? We have a whole heap of money. I buy some of them by friend, you know. We have two friends around them. Sometimes I buy them, buy out them people if you have them. And if they don't have no money, they're not going to see them friend there again. That is not prosperity. Prosper, to prosper, it means nothing missing, nothing broken. And it's in Jesus. It's in Jesus. The giant lodge and say you're going to prosper. That's not prosperity neither. Because it might give you one big business. And it might give you one car and one house and piece of land. And in it you can't even prosper because at the same time, them still, them same one where you join up with the harass you. Yes, they harass you. Them bring sorrow to your life. So you're not prosper neither. No make the devil fool you. You don't go fool out the devil or fool people with words. Words kind of give you nothing free. Everything when you to them people in a lodge and dealer and all of them sitting there where you see people intertwine with. Look here and harass them, and terrorize them. Make them ever forget to carry out one rituals. Make them ever forget to prepare them vows. Make them ever come short of doing something and see what happened to them. But my God, when he bless you, you know, add no sorrow to your life. There is no sorrow. When you come into this prosperity, you can prosper for real. Hallelujah. Now, why would God want this? Why would God want for us as sons to be prosperous? Why? Him, God, have the plan for our money. And that is why financial prosperity is a must where the sons are concerned. We, the Bible says money answereth all things. Where the gospel is concerned with preaching and teaching and delivering people, it takes money just the same. And so God intend for the sons Father, for we as sons to have the wealth. The wealth is supposed to be for us as sons. But we shun it. We put it off. And we talk about material and this and that and reality and what have you. Not having an understanding that it is God's will for us to prosper financially. He has the plan for our money. And when we get to a place where we position ourselves that we can get the wealth into our hand, God is going to tell us how to use the wealth. Amen? And so that is why he wants us to prosper financially. Because the world have the money in their possession. The wicked people have the money in their possession. And them are waste. It has got to waste. Then use all kind of sitting down where you see. They have the money and all them are spending on homosexuality. They have this young man in them bed, this young man in them bed, and all of the man, them and the little boy, them where they can't bow out. They have a waste the money pan. Right? Then indulge in all kind of animal sex and then do whole heap of foolishness and abortion and all of them something the money spend pan. And by care and proud and all kind of sitting down, we give people to carry out this foolishness. Why people out there are dead for hungry? The sons want the money. The son wants the wealth. It is supposed to be in the hands of the sons. So we can take care of the sick, take care of the poor, take care of the needy. Nurture people and bring them in a life. Change life. And so the money is in the wrong hands. Because we as sons have been cultured the wrong way. That you know, all right, for prosper and have money. But I nullify that belief today. I render it powerless. And sons of God, arise. Noah said the world's supposed to be in your hands. And believe God and listen to the Holy Spirit. And what am I do in a this end time? Because there's a prophecy that is supposed to come into place. The wealth of the wicked is supposed to come into our bosom. We supposed to own the wealth of the nations. Think Jesus has come back for one broke church? He now come back for no broke church. He's coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle. And we have spot and wrinkle because we're broke, we're busted, we're confused, and we hate one another because of our life where we are live. We now have no prosperity. All we want to do is dead for go home. And God is saying, look here, I need the wealth to come into your hand. Rub a hole on this wealth because I have something to do with it. I have something to do with it because I'll do it. Then say 1 million people out there, so we are follow up dance and party. You know, look like enough people are got heaven. The devil is a liar because I can assure you that is in this end time when the gospel of the kingdom is being preached. People will get saved when people is being ministered to with wealth. Hallelujah. When the church that have the wealth begin to use the wealth to minister to people, people will come to God. And so I'm here to change that mindset this morning, that you will manifest the abundance that God intends for us to manifest, because it is for God's. The money, the diamond, the gold, the silver, all of it went on the earth of God. And he intend for them to be in the hands of the sons. But people shun these things and put them off. Now if every day you are ball for want and you're in a lock, how you go win souls to God? Oh, because if me out there in a lock and you in a God in a lock, me no want fear God. It's not that God did not make all things for life and godliness where we are concerned already. It's because of how much we willing to trust God. But we not trust God. And as long as you not trust God and they do for your own thing for make life, then God now coming out, it can't work nothing for you. You have to open yourself to see God for who he is and allow him to manifest in goodness in your life. As long as you still do that work, God will not interfere. So you need to understand who is God. That's, I played this song this morning, Be Still and Know. Be still this morning. Be still and know that God is God. And this is his will. It is his will that every need should be supplied. Right? It is God's will that every need should be supplied. And we are walking in lack. That is not happening. Not happening. Success and prosperity is a result of God's grace. It is a result of God's love. There is no such thing as the gospel of prosperity, because prosperity is a result of the grace of God. And the grace of God is a result of the kingdom of God coming to earth. There is no gospel of prosperity. There is only one gospel, and that is the gospel of the kingdom. The gospel of the kingdom show forth all of the finished work of Jesus Christ, which have been made available to us. And so that is why we can't see it, because we don't take the time to look into the gospel. And as a result, we are not prospering like how we are supposed to be prospering. Because the gospel carry the information. Why in a God's heaven would Jesus put so much emphasis that the gospel must be preached? Why you think he put so much emphasis? Pani, if you just take up sitting around with the answer, this is the gospel. No, him said the gospel must be preached. You now need to understand what is the gospel. Because too much people are preaching and say them are preach gospel and they're not touchy. They're not touchy yet. And we are talking about God soon come, and Jesus said, until this gospel of the kingdom is preached for a witness. Come on. Understand it. Get it. It is in the information of the gospel. Our prosperity lies. And so that is why we don't see the manifestations taking place in the earth. Because most of what is being taught and most of what is being preached, it is not the gospel. The gospel means good news. And when you preach legalism and law and judgment upon people, no good news, no, there's something there. No good news, no, it concerning a sinner when you know how to apply to the requirements them who no have. You can't help them because they not have the ability to put up there so to reach the requirements one have set up on one list. And so they need to hear how Jesus good. They need to understand how he saved them, that it is not by any works of man, but it's simple because of his good pleasure, his grace and his mercy. Hallelujah. Are we preaching the gospel this morning? Because we don't preach the gospel, we will not see any manifestation of the gospel, of the grace of God into our life. So I want you to look at Romans again. We are going to go back to Romans. Romans 1 and verse 16. And what Romans 1 and verse 16 is saying, for I am not ashamed of the good news of Christ, for it is the power of God for salvation for everyone who believes, for the Jews first and also for the Greek. You hear? Even the Jews that God give the law to, the gospel, they have to hear it and come to this wonderful salvation. Hallelujah. So we don't continue to preach law and legalism in a church and say we are preaching the gospel, because that is why we have only a form of godliness, and we don't see no manifestation, we don't see no sign, we don't see no wonder, we don't see no healing, we don't see no deliverance, we don't see no prosperity. Why? The gospel is lacking. And so the few people who are preaching gospel, we don't throw a stone upon them and cast them out. People like me will come upon here, come concert this morning, the religious people, they don't like me, because they say me not talk nothing. But I want to say to you this morning, receive the good news and manifest the kingdom of God in the earth. Because it is in the good news, the information is for you. That is why Jesus spent so much time to tell people to them to preach the gospel. In order for you to preach the gospel, you have to study the gospel. Because you are commanded to preach the gospel, you must study the gospel. Study it like you have to go to school and college and study. Go into it. Go into an in-depth study of the gospel. And when you study the gospel, you must also experience the gospel. Because if you don't have no experience of the gospel for yourself, you can't come back come preaching or teaching. You have to experience what you are a part of. That is it. People in a religion, they just talk. Then just preach on something from the Bible and then run with you and talk you every day. And where they're supposed to be experiencing no result now come out of their life. Their life dead and dormant and full of problem and sickness and all kind of something packed up in there and no result now come out. But we are supposed to have experience. Because the Bible said the gospel must be preached for our witness. We are the witness. Now when we can stand up and clearly declare all of the good things that God do for we, then we are a witness. We are a walking witness. Hallelujah. Look upon Paul. Paul's life was a witness where the gospel is concerned. Remember Paul, you know, you can imagine when Paul got through all of what he did that do and he terrorized the Christian and Jesus Christ saved him now. Everywhere he go, he was a witness to the gospel. Because here where Mark said, now look here at me, Paul. I the same Paul this. And me used to terrorize the Christian them. And me used to kill them. And me make sure say the law is uphold. And me this, but Jesus saved me. Me come in contact with Jesus Christ. And when me understand and come to experience the man, me no want to stay in that no more. Me count it all for loss. Is how we preaching the gospel? Because without we preach the gospel, we'll never understand how to manifest what is in the kingdom of God for us. And so, that is why we cannot be ashamed of the gospel. We cannot be ashamed of it. Because it is the power. It is what is going to bring people to God. It's where we're going to manifest the grace of God in our life. It is what we need to look into so we can experience the kingdom. Hallelujah. And so if we never get into this information, if we never study how the kingdom of God works, then look here, we are going home defeat. We are going to go home defeated. We are going to go home defeated. The gospel is where we understand what is in the kingdom for us and how to access them. We as born again sons, it's not that we are going to be blessed or am I blessed, but our blessing is a done deal. It is a done deal where the gospel teaches us what our blessing is about and all of that, it is a done deal. It is a done deal. We are already being blessed with power by God, with all spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ. Now, where is Christ? In us. Hallelujah. We are walking oracles of the blessings of God. Now, the reason why we don't see the manifestation is because of how we are cultured. In the mind. Our minds are not renewed where the kingdom of God is concerned. And so because our mind is not renewed, we still lock up in the old culture. This is something that we know a long time. We will not get to understand and manifest what is on the inside of us. We are in Jesus Christ and where is he in us? Hallelujah. And so all the blessings of God is in Christ. So we have an empowerment. We have an empowerment in financial blessing. And this empowerment that I talk about, we have access to a financial blessing in our life. So even when the bills are past due, you are blessed. Even when you are in debt, you are blessed. Even when you're not dead to your neck, you are in blessings. But how you manifest it? You see, some people know what it is. I know what it is. Let's not even talk about some people. I know what it is to trust God and see the bills them take care of. I know what it is to believe God and see him come true because I've experienced him. But I am experiencing another area of God where you know see the bill them pay, but I am experiencing something else that even though these things are outstanding and they are dear, God is just so awesome and it's something that me experience now. Me can't even tell you because he is still keeping me in spite of what is past, though, in spite of every debt and everything that is piling up around you. Yes, you might see something, my door shut by you on every side. You don't have no more option left. You run out of supply. But I am experiencing the goodness of God in this area of my life just the same. And I can't stand up flat-footed and tell somebody that God is a good God in the midst of everything that is crowded around you. He is still God. I have that experience also. And it's not because me not have faith, but I'm in a process right now. And I'm here to tell somebody this morning that come hell or high water, just believe God because he's coming true for you. He's coming true for you. You have to learn to experience him on some different scale, some different level. And so you might boast and say you know what it is for God provide for you when the bill they need for joy and get the money for pay. But can you experience the liberty, the joy, the peace where you still have all when something outstanding? Have you get to that level? Have you proven God to still be a provider? When everything around you lock up and you don't see a single side, a single way. I'm saying to you this morning, God will come true for you. He will never leave you in that situation. So you don't have to go broke fence. He will never leave you and allow that situation to destroy you. So you don't have to go bow. You don't have to bow to no Satan. Yes, me I talk to your young lady because you don't know where the money I come from. We send a picnic at school all this September. And man, I offer your stuff for sex. Yes, then when you sleep with them. But I say to you this morning, you don't have to bow. Because God will be strong for you. How many don't know how? Hallelujah. Can you go back to where the children of Israel was when God took them out of Egypt? And my God, the mountain was on every two sides. The children of Egypt was coming behind them. And before them was the Red Sea. It seems like there was no way out. But look at God in their situation. God open up. Look here. If at the Red Sea, if you open up for you, send your picnic to school. Just be strong in the Lord this morning. Be strong in the Lord. No gone away. No sell out your God shot. No bow for that. Come in, don't prepare my mind. Say, look here, a British alone, me have to send God school. And if you mean, say, I have to go back in the hallway I've already. I'm going to go back because me not sell myself short for nothing and nobody. I'm going to stand flat footed and I'm going to believe God. You have to get to a place where you say, even if I dead, me I go dead, I'm going to love God and believe him. No matter what, God will be strong for you. The Hebrew boys that did not bow to these idols, they experienced the awesome presence of God. And me I tell us today, look here, God can provide all of your pity need if you go back to school. He can do it. He had no shot. Me say, he had no shot. And no shot. He's capable. The Hebrew boy said, look here, King Nebuchadnezzar. Know this and know this well. We are here to renounce. We are here to tell you this morning that this is it. Our God is able to deliver us and he will deliver us. But even if he not come true, we not bow. He's going to deliver you. He's going to deliver you. It no matter the circumstances where you see. Look here. Me have some something was set up around me like man. Some mountain. But guess what? Every time me hear them threaten me, me say, God, you will be strong for me. Sometimes it's not easy if you stand up in your position. But I say to you, do or die. I'm going to wait until my change come. Because I believe God. He loved me so much that he sent Jesus Christ out of heaven. Look here, whatever I have need of, he has come true for me already. And I know that these needs that are around me, that I don't see no way out to get them, the demands that are on me made, I know that God is going to meet them. So come hell or high water, I am already victorious. It is finished. It is finished. It is finished. So even when the bills are past due, you are blessed. Even when you are in debt, you are blessed. So the problem is not that we are not blessed, but rather how to manifest it. And we hear that we manifest the blessings on the inside by speaking good. Speak. And now when something not change, when you speak, continue to speak. Speak. Don't stop. Speak fruitfulness over your life until the manifestation of it come to pass. Because I'm saying to you this morning, God is not a man that he should lie. I'm here to tell you, as night fall a day, he is going to deliver you. He is going to deliver you. Just continue to speak good over yourself, over your family, over your finance, over your ministry. Whatever it is may be, speak e good. Because that's how you manifest into the natural, what is in this, the spiritual. Philippians 4 and verse 19, let us go there. And Philippians 4 verse 19 says to us, my God will supply every need of yours according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. They hear what the riches there in Christ Jesus. And we have Christ on the inside of us. Right? So we have the answer to a solution. We have the solution to a problem, right? We have the answer, them hyper one list, so, but we need to trust God and believe his words. No, the scripture also say that it is in Christ. Christ in us, the hope of our glory, the one scripture also say. So we have hope this morning because Christ is in us. And notice verse 19. The word need mean demands. So God will supply our demands. The word of God is our receipt for our demands this morning. Whatever it is that is going on in your life, you have a word for it. That is your receipt to say, look here, it is finished. There's something in a place already. Whatever you need, it is already in place. You have the word of God this morning as your receipt, as your valid receipt for what PFR already. Hallelujah to the King of Kings. You have the word of God as your assurance this morning that it is finished. You're now got dead. The situation now got kill you before the time because God have a plan for your life and that plan is to prosper you and to bring you to an expected end. You're now got drop out. The situation now got kill you. The only way he kill you unless you left out of God and go do your own stuff. You understand? Stay in God and believe his word. Our demand is waiting on us to believe what God's words say to receive them. The demand is waiting on us to believe what God's word says to receive them. The word salvation in the Greek means sozo, means born again. The gospel of the kingdom will bring us into all grace. And this means deliverance, the prosperity, the healing, the restoration. To live again, it means to have abundance of life. So prosperity is a finished work. Finished work. Right? It is a finished work where nothing is missing and nothing is broken. All of that which I just mentioned is in salvation. The gospel of the kingdom shows what is in salvation and how to make the withdrawal. So if you never come into understanding what is in the gospel, getting into an in-depth learning about the gospel, then you will not understand how to make the withdrawal from salvation. When you look at the gospel, it is not talking about something that is going to be prepared. It is talking about something that is already prepared for us. It is a done deal. So we have to change the tens. We have to change the tens. And by this now, when we say tens, we mean when we go to school, we talk about past, present, and future tens. We have to understand how our faith works where the tens is concerned. So our faith is not with the present or the future, but is in the past. It is already done. So our faith must be connected to the past. Our present situation is a result of our past provision. Example, bills that are due now is already provided for in the past. Hallelujah. Faith work in the past tense. If we do not have the mindset that things are ready, then there will be no confidence to receive what is done. This morning, if you believe, can you just lift your hands to God and thank Him? Can you just lift your hands to God and begin to thank Him? Can you just begin to prophesy some things out of your mouth this morning? Lift your hands to God this morning and begin to prophesy. Say over yourself, I will never be broke another day in my life. Hallelujah. Begin to prophesy some things out of your mouth this morning. What is in the past? Hallelujah. My past is about to catch up with my present situation. Come on. Can you see? The provision that is already made available in the past is going to be catching up now with your present situation, because the present situation is there. Whatever is opposing you right now, it's because of what is already provided. Hallelujah. Ephesians 1 and verse 3. Let us look at that. Ephesians 1, verse 3. What verse 3 says? Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who had blessed us with every spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ. The word blessed there means the empowerment for great success. Now, when me do me put in the scripture, and where me see blessed, me go read. The empowerment for great success be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has empowered us with great success for every spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ. You hear that? So we are empowered for great success. This grant has been given to us by the grace of God. And so this morning, we need to understand where to live life from. Everything that God makes available to us cannot be received without faith. Nothing that we need to get out of this kingdom system, we will not receive it if we don't put faith in them. Right? So what grace have made available is manifested through faith. Do we believe healing has been made available to us? Yes. Or will it be manifest through faith? There is a difference. I want to say this and say it clearly now, because this is it. There is a difference with us using our faith to get God to do something and using our faith knowing that God has already done it. There's a difference. Because for a long, long time, some people I say God I got do when it is already done. It is already finished. Understand it clearly. It is because it's finished now why you have this confidence. We ask. Understand, you know, at home, I'm a mother. And when my children then come to me and ask me for anything at all, it's because they know that it is there. It is in the house. So if they want something, then come and say, Mommy, can I have a drink or a noodle or something out of the fridge? Why? Because they know that it is in there. It is there for them to have, and so they ask for it. But somehow we are come and we don't know if it did it. We don't believe they did it. And the Bible says, he that come to God must first believe. That is why I'm preparing your mind this morning. I'm telling you that faith work in the past. It is already there. So whatsoever you are going to come to God for now, it is your coming to God knowing that these things has been made available for you. So you don't have no fear, no doubt, no Lord God, no wavering, no double-mindedness about it. You don't have to worry, because it is in the provision. It is in the package of salvation. So we prosper by what we believe is done. Now, when we believe that this is done, what is going to be our action? What is going to be our action when we believe it is done? Until we see physical manifestation, how will we conduct ourselves? How? How we are going to conduct ourselves? Because somehow we say we are believer, and we say we believe in a God, and we say we believe that it's something done for true. But watch we. Here are we murmur, and carry problem and walk up and down all over the place and tell everybody your business and where you know, have and where. Look here, a whole heap of people see me out there and think I'm rich and a whole heap of money. Why? Because I now walk up and down and frustrate people with my problem. I'm not doing it. Because I know who God is and what is already available in the kingdom of God for me. And so when I have my situation and my demands, I know what the word of God says because it is my assurance. I rest and I stand upon God's word. So when we believe, there should be a positive response to what we are believing. We can't say we are a believer and not act a certain way. God has already provided everything that we will need. It is up to us to arrive at the spot. Up to us to arrive at the spot. Let's look at Ephesians 2 and verse 8. Verse 8 said, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourself, it is a gift of God." Our salvation coming by grace is a free gift to us. For we didn't do anything at all but receive. We didn't do anything at all but believe, and we receive it. So in order for us to receive what is in the package of salvation, we must put faith in it and take it out. We must know say did it already. That is why one time when we have problem, we no murmur and wonder and fret. Say what we are going to do. Because daddy make the provisions available. He would never allow you to be born again. And not have your life set. He did not bring Adam and Eve into the garden until it was ready. All that you have need for life and godliness is already made available. Do you believe it? So in order for us to receive what is in the package of salvation, we must put faith in it and take it out. So until we see manifestation, we must abound in grace. We must abound in thanksgiving, in praise and thanksgiving to our God, which is our positive response that we believe. What we are going to do? All when the building pass Joe, we're going to continue to speak good. We're going to continue to thank God for what he make available. We're going to continue to praise him. And we now praise him now like religious people. We get up and say, all right, David and them preach at the end of the Bible, them praise God because when them praise God, things happen. And we're in a church, I make one only panel and I say, praise you, Lord, because something needs to be done in life. And me hear, so when me praise them, I go down. That I not eat, neither you still not get it. You not get it. You need to have a motive. When you understand, say, all we have, the demands and what you have in your life today, I'll already provide for. That is enough to lift your hands and say, Father, I praise you. I thank you. I give you praise. You praise God because you know it is there. You thank him because you know it is finished. So we not praise God out of empty praise. And we praise that come from our lips. But our praise is going to be something of gratitude, of thanksgiving. Hallelujah! Because of what we believe, it is going to be our positive response. It is going to be our praise and our thanksgiving now is what we are going to be factoring in as our faith. When we lift our hands, when we praise God, and it's something that we carry out in our church, when we pay with tithes and we offering, and we offer with gifts to God, it is a means of saying, Lord, because I know that it's already done, this is my praise. This is my thanksgiving. This is my thankfulness to you, God, because me believe you. It is finished. It is done. It is my positive response to what is already made available. Our action, our conduct is our positive or negative response to what we believe. So we can't say we believe. And we see one difference. We not praise God and we not thank him. We are complaining and a murmur and a talk and a doubt. We don't believe. We don't believe because we don't know the word. We don't know what the word of God say about us. We don't have no experience of God. And so because we don't experience him, we don't believe. We don't believe. So that is why we murmur and be fretful and wonder why, if God really going to come true. And the devil know that as long as he dashes sitting them in our life, is to get us to think that what God promised, I think he can't come true with it. But do we believe God that he's not a man that he should lie? If he never spared Jesus Christ, where am I going to keep from you? No good things. 2 Peter 1, verse 3. Let us look at that, and I'm coming down. Verse 3 says, seeing that his divine power has granted to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of him who called us by his own glory and virtue. Faith will only give us what is in the plan of salvation. And so some wallipa people say they have faith. And they use all kind of something now for use faith for. And they say, yeah, man, faith is a thing where you can believe, believe, believe. And once you believe, 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 believe. And that's how you're going to die now. And that's how you're going to die now. Because some people are buying a lot of tickets now and I put all in them Bible. And I say, them I believe God. Faith will not activate what is not in the plan of salvation. So that is why now you must have to know, say, then done. You must have to know what is ready, what is prepared, what is in the will of God for you. So when you know say something finished now, you don't have no problem believing in because you know say done. You see it? And so, faith will only give us what is in the plan of salvation. Right? If you're not in there, lottery not in there. So now put the letter ticket in the Bible and say you're going to believe God for win the lotto. Because you know, in the plan of salvation, that no in a God plan for you know, one everybody just pull up money and put in a one sitting and then one somebody just take your lie and go home. God intend for everybody be blessed and come on. Have all things come on. Right? So it doesn't matter how hard you believe in something. If it is not in the package of salvation, your believing can't take it out. Can't take out when you're in there. It is only what is in there you can believe for. So yeah, in order to say you're a believer, you must know where in there. You must know where in there. You must come to terms with what is in the package of salvation for you. Right? How is your believing? Is it in line with what the word of God says? Is it in line with what the word of God says about you? What was deposited in us was deposited for the redemption of us and for the glory of God. Not to be feeding up our lustful appetite, neither. So God not bless you. Your boast, neither. Right? God not bless you. Your lustful behavior. And so that is why some of us, where the blessings is concerned, we don't really have to see the manifestation of the blessing yet because we don't know how to manage the blessing we come to in life. God has blessed us with some stuff already and we see. We make it go to naught and we take it and do whole heap of foolishness because we were not listening to the voice of God concerning what he has blessed us with already. And so we need for us to be processed. To come to a stage where when he put the blessings and manifest the financial blessings in our life, we won't waste it. We will hear what the Spirit of God is saying through us. And we will adhere to them and carry out what God wants to be done in the earth. It's not to feed up our lustful appetite. We boast upon people and say we're rich and have money neither. But it is all for God's glory and to redeem us. From under our spells and our burden. Hallelujah. We might not see the blessing yet coming into our manifest, coming into manifestation because we are in process. Yes. Some of the time it is not yet. Now I wonder how come God not come true here yet, but you are in process. But don't lose sight of who God is, because he's coming through for you. Don't lose sight. So the word is our assurance to us. We must get the word into our mind. Think on these promises always, and we will manifest what is in our divine nature. Out of our divine nature, we see brotherly kindness. And I don't know if we read Philippians. We need to go further. Go further into Philippians. I only read Philippians 3. Verse 4 said, by which he has granted to us his precious and exceedingly great promise, that through these you may become partakers of the divine nature, having escaped from the corruption that is in the world by lust. Yes, and for this very cause, adding on your part all diligence in your faith supply, moral excellence, and in your moral excellence, knowledge. And in knowledge, self-control. And in self-control, patience. And in patience, godliness. And in godliness, brotherly affection. And in brotherly affection, love. For if these things are yours and abound, they make you to be not idle nor unfruitful to the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Right? So we have to have these things in us. We have to have brotherly affection in us. We have to have love. We have to have self-control. We have to have gentleness. Out of our divine nature, we see brotherly kindness. We see love. We see gentleness. Through manifesting these, we have the knowledge to prosper and be fruitful. So if you now start, feel like you love people and kind to people and gentle to people, you know, you're barren. It means that you need to go back to the word. You need to go get saved. Hallelujah. Because our divine nature carry all of these things. And that is why you would want to reach out to some people now and make sure so they don't get the salvation. That is why you would want to reach out to some people and make sure that the gospel, they hear it. Because you want to see people deliver. You want to see people save. Too much Christians are just comfortable where they are. And they have unsaved loved ones, unsaved friends, unsaved spouses, and then comfortable. They now do not a thing different. They just go to church and go to church Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and follow up the day of the week. And then now do not know where their life is concerned. They see people deliver and come out of luck. Come on. Where is your brotherly kindness? It is these things that will propel your life to see the prosperity. Because these things must be in you for you to understand and come into the knowledge what God is doing for such a time as this, in order to manifest and be fruitful in financial prosperity. God is waiting for the church to understand that this is a part of the gospel. Prosperity, financial prosperity is a part of the gospel. He's going to use us when we position ourselves to bring the gospel to the world. And the gospel to the world is just take talk. You know, just take talk. It take money. And so if we not set ourselves to receive the wealth of God into our bosom, then we will not demonstrate what the kingdom of God have. It takes a lot. And that is why God wants us to position ourselves to manifest the abundance this morning. So if these things are not in us, we are barren, we are unfruitful. There has to be some cooperation to what grace has made available for us. Hallelujah. And so we say grace not automatic. You know, work automatic. The grace of God now just drop out in our life and things change. But we have to cooperate with this grace. Because if you say you're a believer, you need to be responding in faith to what grace has made available for you. And so I leave you with this morning. Right? I leave you with that this morning.
Heavens or the earth to pay the debt of sin for everyone. Who could win the victory over death, hell, and the grave? It's the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Jesus Christ, the Son.
So because he alone is worthy this morning, he had paid the price. The price that he had paid was an awesome price. And this price that he had paid, it's not just for us to continue where we are. It's for us to be delivered. It is for us to manifest what is in the kingdom of God for us. Where luck is concerned, we need to manifest plenty. Addiction is concerned, we need to be delivered. Where sickness is concerned, we need to be healed. And all of these things that I just mentioned, they are under the control of death, hell, and the grave. We need to come into the resurrected presence of Christ. Church leaders, you have been preaching for a long time. But it means if you have to go back to the drawing board, go back, man. Now make pride and then something to turn up in your way. And look here, train people too. Train people and bring up people and put out people. Now just have them a stifle in your hand neither. And you want to do everything and drop down dead before time too. So this is it. If you have to go back to the drawing board, go back. Understand. What is in the message of salvation? What is grace? What is the gospel of the kingdom? And let us feast, man. And let us see God for who he is. Because that is why Jesus emphasized that the gospel of the kingdom must be preached. Because it is in the gospel of the kingdom that we have our solution. We need to hear them before we can see all the awesome manifestation coming into our lives. So I say to you this morning, thanks for listening. Those of you who have tuned in live this morning, thanks for listening to me. Thanks. It was great having you on board, listening to Styles FM, listening to me, of course. This program is called Light in My World. I will see you again next Sunday morning. And so I want to ask that you keep it locked to Styles always, because Styles always have a blessing in store for you where the word of God is concerned. God bless you. Walk good. Until Sunday again.